huge healing. If I can pay it forward and bring somebody a little sunshine because of him.
From a horrific tragedy to a mission of helping others. In the late 1980s, a hate crime ended in the murder of a gay teacher.
News Channel 8's Laura Nichols shows us how the victim's daughter is now carrying on her father's legacy of education. Laura?
Todd and Emily, you might remember the violent murder of Ken Eaton in 1988. Here's the story of his daughter and how she survived to make a difference.
It will be 23 years this February 13th, and he was murdered because he was a gay man.
Ken Eaton was brutally murdered in his West Des Moines apartment.
It was a hate crime, and people remember that.
Billy Green and Gary Titus were convicted of stabbing Eaton to death and then robbing him. His daughter, Jennifer, in high school at the time, was the one who found him.
I've had to struggle with forgiveness and dealing with the loss of my father in the violent way that it happened.
She had one choice.
To either take a terrible thing and either turn it to a good thing, or try to, or curl up in a ball and pretty much just die like your victim did.
She's chosen to become a victim's advocate, and this week unleashed the Ken Eaton Foundation. Its mission?
To create awareness of violent crimes through the voices of victims and survivors.
The foundation gives scholarships, and as a beloved teacher for 20 years, Jennifer said this is what her father would want.
You know, I think he's smiling down from heaven to carry on education and his purpose as a teacher.
As she sifts through old photographs.
You know, he loved the theater. The theater was everything to him.
She's confident his legacy will live on, and so will her message.
And if we were just more an accepting community, civilization, and we just kind of didn't judge people.
Of turning hate into hope.
I think life might be easier, and there wouldn't be so many violent crimes.
To learn more about the Ken Eaton Foundation, go to healinghearts.org. Scholarships can go to kids who are the victim of a violent crime or to someone close to them who was.
All right, thanks for getting the story out, Laura.